So this is how I grew up. I grew up in a wet market in Ho Chi Minh City, in District 3, to be exact. I went to public school all the way to high school. So I came from a very humble background. But my parents, they always knew the value of education. So they would ensure that every time there's an exam to get to a top school, I would be well prepared. So like many other Vietnamese students, my generation, I had good scores, I went to a good public school. And then after the senior year in high school, I won an admissions ticket to study at Stanford University in California. I swear to you all, at that time, I never saw Stanford. I didn't even know Stanford had a red color for their mascot. But I wanted to. So after 4 years at Stanford, I decided to come back to Vietnam. So many of my friends, including my Stanford friends, they told me that, are you wasting your Stanford degree? The wet market was still there, so I would come back to the same home where I grew up. There are many, many risks. What if the ideas that my friends and I would have succeed? What if I couldn't go back to the US? What if, there's so many what ifs. But this is what we were looking at that time. The whole team was looking at the education potential of Vietnam. From before 2004, there were only less than 4,000 Vietnamese students who were studying in the US. Today, there were more than 20,000 studying in the US. So we knew that that was a huge market, and there was a huge need for Vietnamese students to get good education before they study overseas. And so we started at a small room in one of our co-founders' house. At first, our idea was to start an online platform where we can help Vietnamese students prepare for their English and prepare for their IELTS test. But that online idea fell terribly. We ran out of money. So that was a year after we started our idea. What could we do now? So we were looking around and found this townhouse. It's still there to this day on Phạm Ngọc Thạch and Võ Thị Sáu. This is a small building where we rented two rooms, just enough for us to transform from an online to an offline product. So we begged the landlord for us to delay all of the rental for 6 months, because remember, we were running out of money at that time. So these are the first students. We didn't have money, but we still went to the New World Hotel and then asked the students to come to us and then bought them water and convinced them, hey, we have something to share with you. We have our experiences. We have our knowledge of how to study well for the test. So they agreed to try us out. There were only 7 students back then, and these are some of them. And then we tried and tried again. In our second year, we improved our curriculum. We made sure that the students would get good scores and good improvements. So we scaled our model from 7 students to 7,000 students today. We have 6 campuses all over Vietnam. But it's not just about the test score. It's also the vibrant community of non-Vietnamese students that we create. All right, up to here. That's it about selling YOLA. I'm also here to share with you some of the learnings that we had along the way. The first learning was, when we didn't have money, it doesn't matter whether your ideas are ambitious or not, or whether you know, you come from good school. Getting more and more people joining the team was very, very challenging. So we couldn't afford people coming from the best resumes. We couldn't afford to go to, you know, FTU University to host like the Unilever recruiting event. What we could do is that we were looking for people with great passion. They might look, you know, not like the best student in the class, but they're really, really hungry to learn and have the passion. So in this picture, the person second from the right is our first employee. He came in and he was just like, I saw your post on the forum and I want to see how I can help. He didn't know anything about marketing. We trained him and he also learned by himself, and then he taught us. Now he grew to be a great teacher and great product manager. Second lesson, it sounds obvious, but not many companies' education, you'll be surprised, are not doing this. Love and love your teachers. So we are the first education company in Vietnam that are willing to compensate and give the same benefits for Vietnamese teachers as equal as foreign teachers. We don't discriminate based on purely nationality or ethnicity. It's all merit-based. As long as they can demonstrate their qualifications and their passion, then they become our teachers. But that's not enough for loving the teachers. We also create a lot of incentives, and we build our strict quality control system so that all the teachers have the motivation to help the students. Third lesson, which is what I'm still struggling with. What happens when you're frustrated? What happens when you're running out of money? What happens when, doesn't matter how much you try, students might not still improve? Well, you have your teammates, for the more. But you also have the purpose. After 4 years, when we first started, we just had like some burning passion of starting a business. But after 4 years, we were building a purpose, a shared purpose for the whole organization. And for us, that is to develop the future of Vietnam. From changing one individual to growing seeds for the country. But many of you here, you know, we're living in a difficult time. When we inside here, outside of this room, so many things are happening to Vietnam. Many of my friends, many of the senior people, many of the families who come to see us, they ask it. So what's next for Vietnam? Are we sending the best and the brightest of Vietnam overseas? Some of you here today, soon in the future, you might study, work, move to another country. So what's next for Vietnam? I don't pretend I have an answer, in fact I don't. But the best that I can do is to build the best people. So that one day, when change happens, it will come from all of us. And I'd like to end with a quote from an American historian. He said that it is from a lot of countless diversified acts that human history is shaped. So it is a very, very symbolic of how what we're experiencing today. At TEDx, we share different ideas, we respect each other, and we collaborate. And that is the future that we all shape. We might not know what exactly it is. There's no formula. If there's any Vietnamese student out there asking me, you know, give me one formula to succeed overseas. Give me one formula to have the best possible future of Vietnam. There's no formula. It all begins from the different seeds and ideas that we all share today. Thank you.